An adult cow produces about 175 pounds of manure per day. McGill's McDonald campus farm houses 160 cows, plus pigs and chickens, all producing manure constantly. For most of the year, the manure sits in two open pits where it breaks down anaerobically, or without oxygen. This process emits huge amounts of methane, a greenhouse gas 21 times more potent than carbon dioxide. A portion of the manure is sprayed directly on the farm's fields in the spring, but a more digested soil amendment would be healthier for plant growth. A potential solution to this manure problem and the food waste produced on the MAC campus is an anaerobic digestion system. Anaerobic digestion is a naturally occurring process facilitated by many types of anaerobic bacteria. The process goes through four steps as the bacteria turn the initial organic material into methane and carbon dioxide. In this model-sized digester, the input food waste is ground into a slurry and pumped into a tank where the digestion occurs. The outputs of the system are a liquid digestate and a biogas of 50 to 75% methane that can be burned for electricity or heat. The digestate can be separated into liquid and solid fractions, both nutrient-rich, that can be used as soil amendments. The liquid fraction can be sprayed onto the fields like the raw manure. The solid fraction, similar to compost, can also be sold as a high-quality soil amendment. I looked at three options for biogas utilization. One is piping the gas about 1 kilometer from the farm to the lower campus to help fuel the district heating system. A second option is piping the biogas to the four largest farm buildings, the cattle barn, swine complex, poultry building, and old dairy barn, to use in individual burners for heat. These buildings currently rely on a combination of natural gas and more costly propane and fuel oil as a heat source. A third option is creating a district hot water heating system powered by biogas for the four buildings. To use the biogas for heat, a secondary fuel source like natural gas is necessary in case the digester stops working or biogas production doesn't meet the building's heat needs. A dual-fuel burner is needed to accommodate the biogas and natural gas, which have slightly different compositions. While industrial-sized dual-fuel burners exist commercially, the farm buildings need lower-capacity burners, which may not yet be available commercially. Design of burners like this is a key next step in determining the relative costs and benefits of the different fuel use options for the digester. This design will be explored over the next year by mechanical engineering students to further the digester project.